we want to write the equation of the line passing through these two points in standard form. To do this, we're first going to write the equation of the line in slope-intercept form and then change the form to standard form. So we'll use the equation y equals mx plus b. And since we're given two points on the line, we can determine the slope of the line by determining the change in the y-coordinates, or y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by the change in the x-coordinates, or x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So we'll start by determining the slope. If we call these the 1s and these the 2s, that means this will be x sub 1, this will be y sub 1, and this will be x sub 2, and this is y sub 2. So for our line, y sub 2 minus y sub 1 would be 5 minus negative 2 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1, that would be 6 minus 4. So here we're going to have 5 plus 2, that's 7, and 6 minus 4 would just be 2. So again, referring back to slope-intercept form of a line, we now know that y is equal to 7 halves x plus b. But notice how we still have to determine b, or the y-intercept. And we can do this by using one of the given points and substituting in the value for y and x, and then solve for b. Remember, since these points are on the line, they must satisfy this equation. So if we decide to use this first point here, we would substitute 4 for x and negative 2 for y. So let's go ahead and do that. We would have negative 2 equals 7 halves times x, which is 4. So I'll write 4 as 4 over 1 plus b. So we'd have negative 2 equals, now this simplifies here. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2's and 4. So this would be 14 plus b. So now we can solve for b by subtracting 14 on both sides. This would be 0. So we have b equals, this would be negative 16. So now we have enough information for the equation of the line in slope-intercept form. Again, using this equation here, we can now substitute negative 16 for b. So in slope-intercept form, the equation would be y equals 7 halves x minus 16. And now we want to write this in standard form. So we have to deal with two things. First, notice the x and y terms have to be on the left side, and then a, b, and c must be integers. Let's start by subtracting the x term on both sides of the equation. So now we'd have negative 7 halves x plus y equals negative 16. The next thing is, notice the coefficient of x is a fraction, so we can't leave it in this form. So to clear the fractions, we'll have to multiply everything by 2. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll multiply this by 2, we'll multiply this by 2, and we'll multiply this by 2. Notice here the 2's simplify out, and we're left with negative 7x plus 2y equals, this would be negative 32. Now this is the equation in standard form, but there is one more thing that you often see. A lot of times it's preferred if the coefficient of x is positive rather than negative. So we could multiply everything by negative 1 so that this would be positive 7 rather than negative 7. So let's go ahead and show that as well. We'll multiply the left side of the equation by negative 1 and the right side by negative 1. So the equation in standard form could also be expressed as 7x minus 2y equals positive 32. So you'll probably find this form a little more common, but this form here is also acceptable. These two equations are equivalent, and notice that the x and y terms are on the left, and all the coefficients are integers. So just be sure that you understand these two equations are equivalent.